This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at the Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about the GCD-LCM product theorem. So let's start out just by explaining what all this means. So GCD is the greatest common divisor or greatest common factor of two numbers. LCM is the least common multiple of two numbers. And there's a theorem that shows the relationship between the greatest common divisor and the least common multiple. So let's find out what that theorem is and then see how we use it. Okay, so I'm going to start out with the numbers 6 and 15. And let's say I want to find both the greatest common divisor and the least common multiple. Well, I can do both of those things by getting the prime factorizations. So the prime factorization of 6 is 2 and 3. The prime factorization of 15 is 3 and 5. So that means that the greatest common divisor or greatest common factor of 6 and 15 would be, let's see, well, the only number they have in common is 3. And the least common multiple of 6 and 15, I would find that by taking all of the factors of one of the numbers. Let's take all the factors of 6. So that's, I've got a 2 and a 3. It's all right, 2 times 3. And then I'm also going to multiply 2 times 3 by any factor of 15, which is not a factor of 6. Well, 5 is a factor of 15, but not a factor of 6. So I'll have 2 times 3 times 5. Now, the GCD-LCM product theorem says something like this. If I take the GCD of these two numbers, if I take the 3 and multiply it by the least common multiple of those two numbers, the 2 times 3 times 5, I'm going to get the same thing as if I multiply 6 times 15. So let's see. 6 times 15 is 90. 6 times 15 equals 90. And if I multiply 3 times 2 times 3 times 5, 2 times 3 is 8 is 6, and 6 times 3 is 18, and 18 times 5 is 90. So the GCD times the LCM is going to be equal to the product of the two numbers I'm dealing with. So I can write this in a kind of a general way. Let's write the rule. So the GCD of two numbers, let's call them A and B, times the least common multiple of those two numbers, A and B, equals A times B. Now let's say I want to find what the least common multiple is. Well, I could divide both sides of this equation by the greatest common divisor. So if I divide both sides by the GCD, I'm going to have the GCD, let's see, dividing them both by the GCD. So what I end up with is that the least common multiple of two numbers, A and B, is equal to A times B, the product of those two numbers, divided by the greatest common divisor of those two numbers. Now, once we get all these letters, this seems kind of abstract and confusing. So let's apply that to some real numbers. So let's say I want to find the least common multiple of 18 and 30. Well, the first thing I'm going to do is find the greatest common divisor of those two numbers. So let's see. That means I've got to factor down 18 and 30 into prime factorizations. So 18 is 2 times 9, and 9 is 3 times 3. So I've got this factorization tree. And that means that 18 is 2 times 3 times 3. And 30 is 3 times 10, and 10 is 2 times 5. So my prime factorization for 30 would be 2 times 3 times 5. And if I want to find the least common multiple, I'm sorry, I want to find the greatest common divisor first. If I want to find the greatest common divisor, I'm looking for factors that these two numbers have in common. They've both got a 2, and they've both got at least 1 3. So the greatest common divisor is going to be 2 times 3. So the GCD of 18 and 30 is 2 times 3, or 6. And now I'm going to use my rule. Let me rewrite that fact, that GCD equals 6. And I'm going to take the product of the two numbers. Let me make some room. So the LCM of 18 and 30 is going to equal the product of 18 and 30. So that's 18 times 30 divided by the greatest common divisor of 18 and 30. Well, the greatest common divisor was 6. So now I've got 18 times 30 divided by 6. I can divide both the denominator and the numerator by 6. So I'll divide the denominator by 6 and just get a 1. I'll divide this 18 by 6 and get a 3. And that means that my least common multiple of 18 and 30, it would be 3 times 30, and that's 90. Okay? So once again, the basic process goes something like this. You've got to find the least common multiple. You find the greatest common divisor, and you divide that greatest common divisor into the product of the two numbers you're dealing with. Okay, simplify that division problem, and that's going to give you the least common multiple. Okay, so you might want to try this sometime when you want an alternate way to find the LCM for something. Okay, that's it for now. Take care, and I'll see you next time.